So good afternoon, everyone, and thank you very much again for today. I did the welcome introduction at the beginning of the day, and I stand here humbly in front of you, and it's been just a wonderful day to communicate and talk to everyone, and so glad that you stuck around for, well, I want to think for this presentation, but maybe it's happy hour that follows, but I think it's for the presentation. But to wrap up the day, I have the pleasure of officially opening Anker's 2023 Tool of the Year Award. And this is a program that we introduced back in 2018 to recognize the art of tool grinding. And in doing so, it sort of blew and grew into just a phenomenal program that attracted contestants from around the world. And it's all about recognizing the art of tool grinding. Okay, we connected to being ground on an anchor and being made to print. And there's criteria in terms of surface finish. But, you know, that's the roll-on effect. The real art is appreciating the passion that many of our users have in the use of their CNC tool grinder. So this was an industry's... Oh, I've got to click the button, sorry. It was an industry's first competition. As I said, we released it in 2018, and it's grew, and look, it's a high-profile... prestige award, we feel, and that the value that people that submit their tools from around the country also see it that way. They use it in terms of marketing and promoting, and you've seen a display of some of the tools that that have been past winners and runners up there. It truly is recognizing that that art of specialty. It also allows the companies to recognise their employees and the skills that they bring to the table. We like to promote that we have the easiest CNC tool grinder on the market, but its real value is the person that pushes the buttons and moves around within the program, the software. And we feel that's the person that we also want to recognise in the Tool of the Year Award. It is a true celebration of craftsmanship that we want to stress to the market. So one of our special guests speaking tomorrow, Alfred, if you put up your hand there, Alfred Leon, very active in social media, but is true to our heart. Alfred's been involved in Anker Tool a year since its innovation, and he came up with this statement that really does magnify our belief in what Tool of the Year brings to the market. It's the grinding community that has so much knowledge and passion of their own media channels, and every day you see new posts, and I don't know if you're on social media today in terms of Facebook and LinkedIn, and you're seeing people within our industry on anchors, non-anchors, posting pictures of their craftsmanship tools online. Alfred's happy to be part of the competition and celebrate the craft and recognise the fantastic, beautiful tools that our community makes. So, you know, we feel that, okay, it's a plug for Anker, but we also have found that it brings exposure to the contestants, and that's probably a good word, contestants, but for our customers and innovators and craftsmen to enter. You know, the advantage, the roll-on effects, over 200,000 impressions on Facebook, 16,000 engagements on social media, over 200,000 engagements across a wide stream of media sites, 4,000 votes achieved on Facebook, because in the end it's your peers that that make the decision on who goes to the finals. So fantastic recognition that's achieved from social media. Archer's tool submission had one of the highest reactions of 227 and over 30 shares just last year on Facebook. And of course, we stream it live around the world, and over 12,700 announcements were made across Facebook and other social medias. So we think there's some good exposure to be gained from it. So some of the past tools that have made the category winners and runners-up since its innovation, and it's very hard to see it on the screen. The same tools are positioned over there, a majority of them. Just some wonderful craftsmanship in the tools. So the criteria for it is that they have to be workable tools. So they have to be a customer tool. They have to be made to a print. They have to meet the criteria of tolerance based on the print, surface finish criteria based on the print, and of course, being made on an anchor. So in announcing the 2023 Tool of the Year, we have a number of categories, two categories to enter in, made on anchor and the most innovative design tool, and one's a virtual and the other one's a real cutting tool. The winner of the made on anchor gets a trip to Anchor's headquarters in Melbourne, Australia, up to $10,000 AUD worth of Australian dollars, sorry, worth of Anchor parts, accessories, and software, and access to some additional VIP training from the Anchor experts. And then the most innovative tool design, so again, virtual tool, is up to $10,000 Australian dollars worth of Anchor parts and accessories. And if you recall last year, if you're close to it, some of the virtual tool designs were just fantastic. I mean, one of them was the Taj Mahal on a 3D. One was a flying bird, flying hummingbird, and its eye was done by fooling the simulator that it was a coolant hole of a drill. And so the creativity of the people was fantastic. One of our own guys made, help me out here, Dan, Pac-Man from the 3D simulator through the use of tool design, and not quite sure how he did it, but Dan did assure me he did it in his own time. So, the judges, Anchor co-founder Pat Bolan, external customer Turkar out of Turkey, and Darren Fox and Santosh, a couple of the product managers are here. So it comes down to a selection of five tools, I believe, and we have the judging panel's review. We are introducing a third award. We want to recognise diversity that we're bringing to the company, and it's not catching on to something that should be seen as politically correct. It's actually further from the truth. We see so much more of ladies coming into our business. We have them as applications engineers, even within our own company, from very smart engineers at the factory. And we've trained many ladies that customers have. And so we want to recognise the female machinist that is operating an anchor with an anchor award connected to Anchor Tool of the Year. Look for that on social media. There's more details to come on how that program will operate. But we're looking to recognise the same passion and art form that the ladies bring to the CNC tool grinding industry. So, tool of the year since 2018, maybe a slightly better group of pitches. We've had a fantastic series of entries from Arch Cutting Tools. A number of years they've actually won the award, a couple of years being runner-up, and we're proud to have Arch as one of the leading cutting tool companies in the US that sees the vision and the, without putting words into their mouth, the vision and exposure to participating in Anchor Tool of the Year, and we're hoping that others will see that as well. So with that, I would like to ask Arch Cutting Tools to come up and just say a few words related to Anchor's Tool of the Year program. And for that, I'm happy to introduce Jeff Cederstrom, president of Arch Cutting Tools, to say a few words, and followed by Jim Gray, regional director of operations, also of Arch Cutting Tools. So with that, thank you, Jeff.
So it wasn't that long ago that Russell and I shared a podium when Arch won the 2020 award, and we actually hosted the award ceremony at our Latrobe facility. That's where we actually manufactured the part, and so Russell and I did the presentation there and did it in front of the team that manufactured and helped design the tool. So thank you to Russell and the rest of the Anchor team for having asking Arch to come and present and talk about the value that we see in Anchor Tool of the Year. So Jeff Cederstrom again, president of Arch Cutting Tools. And so to share a few of my thoughts on the Anchor Tool of the Year. I've said this before, but I see this as a very friendly industry competition that really has the opportunity to raise the bar for the industry, to gain some additional interest from folks that are out there and potentially, interested in expressing a career or learning more about the technology of cutting tools. In a sense, it's extremely humbling for, a local group to be able to compete against some of the brightest minds in the industry on cutting tool design, and not only competing against folks in your state or in your country, but this is international competition of folks that are really passionate about cutting tools. So in a sense, it's I view this as an Olympic design of cutting tools of sorts, and it's really a chance for the folks within our organization to share ideas in amongst each with each other. A lot of times we spend quite a bit of time talking about how long it takes to train someone to become a good operator in the trade, and that depending on who you ask, it's quite some time. But you're never done training, you're never done learning, you're never done expanding the trade. So it's a chance to share ideas internally, and it's also a chance to see other ideas that other organizations, cutting tool manufacturers, have come up with. A bit about Arch Cutting Tools. We manufacture tools across the full spectrum. We have quite a large portfolio of standard tools, but we also specialize in custom tooling. And we've designed and built the company in and around custom tooling, and so in a sense, the business units, as we call them, that have joined the company, it's in their DNA. So it's my job to work with a number of very highly successful entrepreneurs, and so if anyone in the audience has any ideas on how to lead and coordinate and get a common vision for highly innovative entrepreneurs, please see myself, Jim, and Jonathan after the meeting, because it's a fun ride with Arch Cutting Tools. There's a lot of passion. I'd like to reframe that. I said we specialize in custom tooling. I'll reframe that in a way that says our customers are requiring more and more custom tooling out of our organization. They're requiring more and more highly complex application-specific designs to meet their needs and to reduce their costs, reduce the CPU, they're also the timeline that's associated with their expectations is, I'll tell you, it's not getting longer. It's getting shorter and shorter. So it's for some of those reasons that I support the Anka Tool of the Year program. And then it's also one of the reasons that we enjoy the partnership between Arch and Anka, as Anka is evolving the technology and helping us with the enabling technology to come up with the designs faster and the manufacturing consistency to get those custom designs out into the marketplace. Russell showed a slide with some statistics on the social media and the benefits of the tool of the year, and certainly I'll list a few for Arch Cutting Tools. Certainly we have benefited externally. Our sales team routinely cites the participation and the recognition of the tool of the year with our customers. We've Russell hinted on this a little bit, but we've also seen this benefit our ability to attract employees. There's folks that are out there. We got a fairly big LinkedIn following, and there's a lot of techies out there that are very curious and seeing, and they kind of get into seeing the evolution of what's going on out there in cutting tools, and so we're generating some interest, and that helps us with employment. Believe it or not, Anka Tool of the Year has also helped us when we do acquisitions. So we've got continue to acquire companies that share our culture, share our vision, and build out our custom tooling capabilities. There are folks that pay attention to this in the industry, and so it gives us some credibility even when we're out there doing acquisitions. We tried to get some of the bankers excited about the Anka Tool of the Year, and it kind of falls on deaf ears with those folks. But all the other folks out there are extremely interested and pay attention. The last one, I think is probably the most important to me. I mean, the external notoriety is great, but internally, Arch culture is extremely important to us, and bringing multiple business units together and coming together as one cohesive organization to the marketplace, we have to really focus on our culture, and one of the facets of that culture is engagement, and so we use, and Jim's going to talk about it some more when he comes up here, but we use the Anka Tool of the Year Award to engage employees and to get ideas and to bring them from across the company. We're a decentralized organization, so we host Zoom calls and we get ideas in from around the organization, and it helps generate excitement. And our marketing team has done a great job of also generating some excitement when the awards are being announced. They publish a link, not only within Cutting Tools, but also within our Arch Medical segment, so that we can, everybody gets to participate and kind of see, and get some energy from the overall process. And again, I give our marketing group some credit. The tool, one of the tools, the 2020 tool that was showing up there, they figured out a way to get that on a T-shirt. So, all the different facets of that cutting tool was spread around to those that were involved in a T-shirt. Wanted to share one example that kind of exemplifies, the engagement and the cultural piece of this, and it has to do with when we won the award at the Latrobe team. There's one of our operators named Justin McGee. He was so proud of winning the Anka Tool of the Year that he took took a printout. I don't know if it was a picture of everybody out in front of the building, if it was actually the award itself, took a printout and took it home to his family and put it up on his mantle, and because he was so proud that he works for a company that won the award. So it's kind of a cool story, and it gives you kind of additional motivation to keep the folks focused. So I would encourage anyone who's involved this year to engage your teams, and I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to Jim Gray, and for all those that are participating, may the best design win this year.
Good afternoon, everybody. Jim Gray, operational director for regional operation director for Arch Cutting Tools. Just to kind of touch on what Jeff just left off of there, you know that story with the, you know, multiple people and probably a lot of people in the room, passion, you know. So I want to lead out talking about even myself right out. You know, I've been doing this for 30 years now, and 24 years of that has been with ANCA, partnership with ANCA throughout my journey. You know, just like most of us here, you know, we start out in our jobs wanting to make money and having a career, right? Not knowing where we're going, what we're doing. So just like myself, that led into my passion. You know, this is something that, you know, for all those years, the passion, to be creative, innovative, to compete, just like a lot of people here. You know, this is what drives us. It's so common. And that's why I look at ANCA. ANCA is a very passionate company. You know, I've worked with Russell and the team, both Pats, over the years, thinking about the innovation, the passion throughout the whole organization around the world. ANCA has been top notch. And watching the growth and where we are today has allowed Arch and our competitors to be competitive, have the passion, be able to be innovative and be fast at what we do. So, thinking about Pat Bowlen and Pat McCluskey, just looking at the timeline on the wall is so impressive. You know, they were first in a lot of things they've done. And it's pretty awesome to hear the stories. I've heard it many times. And it's what you and others, we want to become and want to do in our own business. We want to grow and be the best at what we do. And I think with the competition has allowed Arch and some of our other competitors that I think about, really stand out with their craftsmanship and what they do. The ANCA Tool of the Year, in the competition, with Arch, has allowed Arch and the competitors to join a friendly competition to show not only our capabilities, but the capabilities of the ANCA machine. So thinking about the technology changes over the year, the software, the linear drives, everything that's made us be better at what we do. The fine, looking at the new Ultra, thinking about that innovation, the next step of what we do, it's brilliant. And the technology and the team at ANCA still continues to amaze me. So thinking about, Arch is a solution-driven tool company. We make standards, no doubt. But our passion and the biggest percentage of our company is creating tools, taking multiple tools and turning them into one. And that's what you've seen in a lot of our entries and some of our competitors' entries. That just gives us a little leading edge in the industry to do great at what we do. So with ANCA Tool of the Year starting out today, I just like to reflect on, why we participated at Arch. Arch Cutting Tools is made up of 16 business units around the country. And our first win was with Contour 360. That was pre-acquisition. What a great team, and I have the pleasure to be a part of that team, be the manager over top of Arch Main now. And what I see there is just great craftsmen. I walk in there and so proud, and I think about when we touch on what we all do, if it's a machine builder or a tool maker, all these things align together, the passion, the innovation. And I continue to say that. It leads us in the path to make us all great at what we do. So the following year, I think, look at 2019, I believe it's the first time Arch entered as Arch, under Rhode Island, I believe it was. Unfortunately, I don't think we won that year, but KB Tool came in first place, a great company. And that's why I love in this competition, it brings out companies maybe you never heard of or, that's locally or around the world. I love that. The following year, came 2020. And this is a story I really want to tell because this is what really Arch is about, the synergies, you know, how we come together and work as a team. It is awesome. Actually, you know, just seeing us all as we acquired the next company coming in, we were competitors. And now we're teammates. Takes a little road to get there, but we get there. We get the walls down. So thinking about 2020, we pull a meeting together. The marketing team says, okay, we're going to enter the Tool of the Year. And Latrobe is excited because we've heard of the competition. We just never entered it. So we pull a meeting together with managers across the company. And at the time, you know, I think about, you know, we went to this first meeting. Let's get our ideas. Come back next week. We come back next week. We get on the call. So clearly we start talking, and I remember Jonathan Wild says, I got two entries. But Jim, please, let's see what you got. And I was like, okay. So I started talking about our design and what we had. And after I was done presenting what I had, when we had multiple people in line, Jonathan was like, yeah, I'm not showing you ours. That's the Tool of the Year. So that's where we started. It was pretty cool. We were excited to present, you know, what we do at a high level. And we thought, we didn't know, we just thought we had a good chance at it. So that's what I love, because it's been fun. And Jonathan and I, we, you know, used to be competitors, and here we are collaborating, and it's been really good, through the process. So just thinking about, you know, that put Arch in the Tool of the Year in motion. I feel, you know, we kind of changed the competition a little bit. We stepped up the game. And I think sometimes about us, like, I wish we would have kind of held back a little bit because, you know, the next year, you know, look what happened, you know, Takar. You know, Takar came out and dominated. And I never heard of the company. And I was like, wow, these guys really got it together. And not only with the tool, the physical tool, but the virtual. Just amazing. Just craftsmanship, innovation, design. It was awesome. In the same year, JG Group also... company I never heard of, alongside with the virtual, just and even their tools that they produce, just amazing companies that I wasn't aware of, and it's awesome to compete in this. And like I said, friendly competition is beautiful. I love it, still love it. So and then the following year, you know, we go at it. We didn't win the 2021, but it just opened our eyes what was going on with this competition, and it really brought out some really creative, passionate companies, and that's what it's about. In 2022, SG Tools from Mexico got first place, and we've got runner-up. So it's still, why do we do it? You know, I think about, people see us, we come back, we do it. Our team is so proud, passionate, competitive, innovative, that it drives us to be out there and participate. And that's why it's such a great competition for us to show our craftsmanship and what we do. And alongside of Anka, what they have to offer every year, something different, you know? A new step of the game with the machines, the software, what's next? And Anka always comes up something new the next year. So, you know, I think very proud of our company overall. You know, throughout all our business units, I get to work with these people every day, and it's pretty amazing. And just like some of you in here, you have a great team, and you keep reflecting on what's the next thing. Just like Anka, what's next? How do we be better, you know? So very good stuff. You know, in Arch, you know, we collaborate as a large team over business units, using our synergies to be competitive as we can. Every year, new ideas, you know, they're made up by different employees. The design is by a different employee. Who manufacture the tool is a different employee. That's what's awesome about Arch. It's not always the same person that does the design or making the tool. So again, you know, This competition allowed us to, you know, be a friendly competition, allowed us to show the world what we do. And I'm excited to see what's brought to the table this year. It'll be interesting to see what's next, because I'm thinking, how can anybody be more creative than what we've seen from all our competition and, you know where the competition started. I just want to thank Anka. It's awesome to be here today with everybody here. And I love, seeing the competition that we have out there. Be creative, passionate, innovative. That's I think, who we all are. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Jim. Thank you, Jeff. Appreciate nice words, but, you know, hopefully it sort of opens up the playing field to entrance into Anka's Tool of the Year. So I'm pleased to announce the official opening of the 2023 Anka Tool of the Year. Get your submissions in, please. The winner will be announced in September at EMO 2023, so you've got time to get the teams together, start planning, and as Jim said, be creative and get on the edge a little bit. And with that, I thank you very much again for the day. Happy hour began 20 minutes ago, so let the games begin there for happy hour. But again, thank you very much for the day. And for those coming back tomorrow, I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. And Anka Tool of the Year 2023, may the best design win. Thank you.